Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it.
You are kind, Almighty God. You are good, you are kind, Almighty God. You are good, you are kind, Daddy, Almighty God. You are good, you are kind, Almighty God. I will praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart, with my whole heart. I will praise Him, precious people, praise the Lord. Oh, my sister, praise the Lord. Oh, my brother, praise the Lord. Everybody, praise the Lord. God is good. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God is good. First and foremost, I want to appreciate you, my viewers, for joining me to thank God yesterday for the life of our mother in the Lord, Mommy Folu Adeboye, whom God added another year to her years. And I want to say that as we have joined to pray for her, God Himself will pray for you. The Holy Spirit will help you in the name of Jesus. And I want to appreciate God on behalf of those of you who are baptized with the Holy Spirit yesterday. Without any doubt, I know some of you have been baptized with the gift of the Holy Spirit. And I want to say, keep speaking in tongues, so that your faith could be built, so that you could always pray rightly according to the will of God. Shall we please pray? Everlasting Father, everlasting Son, immortal Spirit, be thou glorified. Father Divine, we want to thank you. Holy Spirit Divine, we want to appreciate you. Thank you for your ministry in our lives. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. It's another day, O God, to be taught by you. Lord, reveal yourself to us through your word today in Jesus' name. Reveal your word, yourself to us, my Father, through your word, that our lives might be built in Jesus' name. If you reveal your word this day, backsliders will see where they have fallen and they'll be able to make amends. If you reveal your word, my Father, saints will be encouraged to become better in their work with you. Through the word this day, wherever we have all missed it, help us to make amends in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today is Friday, 14th of July. Friday, 14th of July. And our topic is a form of question. Foundation, how strong? We all know that it's the foundation that bears the load of the house. The foundation of a house determines how high the house will be. If you want to build a five-story building, the foundation cannot be like a bungalow. You know it will collapse. So the stronger your foundation, the higher you go in the Lord. Foundation, how strong. Our memory verse is taken from 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 19. 1 Timothy 6:19. Laying up in store for themselves a good foundation against the time to come, that they may lay hold on eternal life. Are you laying a good foundation for yourself? Are you building your foundation strong in the Lord so that you will not be able to miss eternal life? So that you'll be able to live a life that is pleasing unto the Master. So that you'll be able to withstand the storm of life. If the foundation is not strong enough, when storm comes, the building will collapse. When your foundation in the Lord is not strong, challenges of life will cause you to lose focus of Him. May that not be our portion in the name of Jesus. Foundation, how strong. Our text is taken from Psalm 11, verse 3 to 5. Psalm 11, verse 3 to 5. If the foundations be destroyed, what can the righteous do? The Lord is in His holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold, His eyelid try the children of men. The Lord tries the righteous, but the wicked and him that loveth violence, his soul hateth. Before we go into the open heavens, there's a question here that you and I need to answer. It says, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? That means we need to look to the issue of foundation. So many marriages are collapsing today because their foundation was not based on Christ, the rock. So many businesses are folding up today because the foundation was wrong. It was not built on Christ. Any foundation that is not laid on Christ will crumble. Be it marriage, be it pursuit of career, be it your education, be it business, anything and everything. Be it ministry. If the foundation is not Christ, when the storm of life begin to beat, such building will collapse. So you need to check that as a righteous person, foundation matters. Foundation matters. As a child of God, foundation matters. You have just come to Christ. Let your foundation be strong. Some people, they will come to Christ yesterday and today. They say they have been called into the ministry, they are preaching. What do you know already? Let your foundation be strong. Let God build you up first. Let Him toughen you first. Foundation matters. You want to go into marriage? Let the foundation be Christ. Don't let it be wealth. Oh, that brother is loaded. He worked with an oil company. That brother is loaded. He has international job. There are problems that money cannot solve. But if Christ is the reason why you are marrying that fellow, if Christ is the foundation for that, to me, Christ is the one leading you into that relationship, you can be sure that home will stand. God will help us in Jesus' name. If foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? So if foundation is not strong, it will be destroyed. So the righteous here need to pray so that the one who has all power can rebuild any defected foundation. The foundation of any building or structure is very important, according to Proverbs 22:6. Proverbs chapter 22 and verse 6. He says, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. Telling us that the time of training is when the child is young. Because the Bible says, when he's old, he will not depart from it. Foundation. Are you laying the foundation for the life of your child or children? If you don't train them, when they are still malleable, they are like fresh fish. When they are still young, when you tell a child this is the way to sit, the child will be sitting like that. This is the way to eat. This is the way to do things. The child will take it just like that. But after the child has grown, he has become an adult, he has chosen his own pattern of doing things, you now want to introduce new virtues or principles to the child will resist. The Bible says, train a child, not train an adult. Look at your Bible very well. Train a child, not train a man, not train a woman, a child. Lay solid foundation for your children when they are still young, when they are still tender. We all know who is a child. You can't consider a girl of 18 to be a child. You can't consider a man that is 23 to be a child. Train your child the way it should go. So let's continue. Daddy says, if a child is given the right foundation, it will be easy for him or her to build on it and succeed in life. If, for instance, you have taught your child, when you wake up in the morning, before you speak to any human being, speak to God first. Commit the day to God's end. That child will grow up like that to open his eyes to say, Father, I thank you for watching over me throughout the night time. That child will grow up to pray about everything and everything. He's going to school, he will pray. He wants to start writing an exam in the class. When in school, he will pray. He has finished writing his exam, he will pray. He's returning back from school, he will pray everything, because that is the way you have tutored him. Train your child, give them good foundation. The question then is, what kind of foundation are you laying for your child or world? Do you know that some parents are the ones who push their children into destruction? You may say, how can a parent do that? Let us explain. According to Daddy here, which is nothing but the truth, some of us, because of fame, some of us because we want name, some of us, because of class, we want to belong. A child that does not know the right hand from the left hand, we will put them in a boarding school abroad, in a different culture, in a different environment, in the Western world, where anything goes. So the child will now grow up doing evil. The child might now grow up to say, yes, he is believing in gay marriage. Because that's what he grew up to see and to know as what happened around him. He doesn't have his own mind before you send him into the larger society where anything goes. So you just end up helping to destroy your own child. Let's read it in Daddy's language. Daddy said, do you know that some parents are the ones who push their children into destruction? For instance, if you have a child whose Christian foundation is not solidly established, and you send such a child into a society with liberal values, don't be surprised to see that child follow an ungodly lifestyle. For this reason, when you are considering tertiary education for your child, also put into consideration how that child will access spiritual growth, in the situation you want to send him or her to. Like I said, some of us, we do these things because we want to belong. So and so, all the children are studying in the U.S. I want my children to go to the U.S. This so and so, my neighbor, all the children are studying in the U.K., they're in Europe. I want my children there also to go. Have you considered their spiritual strength, their spiritual stamina? Are those children you want to send out strong enough to withstand the challenges out there? How many of those children of your mates, colleagues, or what have you are referring to are spiritually strong? Immediately, some groups out there, they become prostitutes. Some, the moment they go out there, they join different cults. Some, the moment they go out there, because they've not gotten the strong Christian foundation from home, anything goes. They begin to smoke, they begin to take hard drug. And you now begin to say, oh, it's one witch in your compound that is bewitching your child. No witch is bewitching your child. You are the cause of your own trouble because that child has not been given proper Christian values before you push him or her into the larger community with liberal values. Their children are being protected. They have their own mind. Let them think. Let them do whatever they want. Some will even change their sex. They are not happy they are a man. They want to become a woman. They are not happy they are a woman. They want to become a man. And the law permits it. If they are well grounded in the faith, if they already know who the Lord Jesus Christ is, by the time they go out there, instead of the world influencing them, they will influence the world. They will become a world changer. God will help us in Jesus' name. Let's continue. Daddy says, for this reason, when you are considering tertiary education for your child, put into consideration how such a child will assess spiritual growth. An ideal school should be able to satisfy the academic, moral, extracurricular, and spiritual needs of a child. So if you have any reason to send your child to another nation, particularly Western world, where there are liberal values, you need to look for a particular school where their spiritual life will be a concern. All this should be well balanced. A child's foundation is laid from kindergarten to university. Deuteronomy 6, 4 to 9. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4 to 9. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy might. And these words which I command thee this day shall be in thy heart. And thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children. And shalt talk of them when thou sittest in thy house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. And thou shalt bind them for a sign upon thy hand, and they shall be as frontlet between thy eyes, and thou shalt write them upon the post of thy house and on thy gates. So you have to teach these children when they are young. Teach them the word of God. As we are working together in the house, as a mother, they are doing the dishes, you teach them the word of God. Teach them. As we are working, maybe you are taking a stroll or you are going to the marketplace or wherever you want to do one thing or the other, teach them the word of God. Always teach them the word of God. When you teach them when they are young, when they grow up, they become spiritual giants. So Daddy is saying a child foundation is laid from kindergarten to university, after which the child will be able to continue in the righteous path of his or her upbringing. Do your children have a solid foundation in Christ? Is their foundation strong enough to carry whatever will be built on it? On the other hand, the strength of a child's foundation is a function of several factors, such as 1, the spiritual level of the parent. The mother who never opened the Bible to read herself, how can she teach a child to study the Word of God? The mother who doesn't know how to pray, the father who never prayed, how will such parents bring up a child with godly virtues? Parents themselves who will only go to church 3 times in a year. They go on Christmas Day, they go on New Year Day, they go during Easter, QED. So how will children of such people grow up to be spiritually strong? Then that is the values upheld in that family. For any child to grow spiritually, to have strong foundation, it depends on the value upheld in that family. Some family, anything goes. But some family will tell their children, we have a name to protect in this family. So as a child in this family, you dare not take whatever does not belong to you. What are the values upheld in your family? The parents' level of education. Some people, because they are not educated, they don't know the value of education, and they don't bother that their child should be educated. The financial resources available to the child, and so on and so forth. It is true that you cannot give what you don't have. This invariably means that as parents, the more you invest in your spiritual life, the greater the chances of giving your children a more solid foundation. If you yourself, you always study the Word of God. James 1:25. James chapter 1 and verse 25. It says, but whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continue therein, he be not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. When you as a parent, you are always looking to the Word of God, meditating on it according to Psalm 1 verse 1 and 2, Psalm 119 verse 97. You're always meditating on the Word. Then you are able to give a solid foundation to your children. You're always studying the Word according to 2 Timothy 2:15. When you build yourself up spiritually yourself in the place of prayer, 1 Timothy 5:17 says we should pray without ceasing. When you are the type that we always pray, you yourself, you'll be strong. But if you have not been building yourself up, you have not been studying the Word of God, you have not been prayerful, you have not been committed to God, how can you now tell your children to do so? Even if you say they should do so, they will not be able to do it because they don't find it in you. Children learn a lot by simply copying their parents. So children can be called copycats. That's why you see some children, when they walk, they say, this is how daddy walks. They'll be walking like their father. Many parents engage in certain unhealthy habits, and their children are watching them. The laughable thing is that some parents who practice unwholesome habits even want their children not to try such. To believe that their children will take them seriously is to engage in self-deception. If, for instance, you tell your child, hey, that woman is coming. Whenever she comes, tell her I'm not around. The child knows you are around. And so when they come to her, mommy, I just step out. You mean you don't meet her on the way? Indirectly, you are teaching that child to lie. Before you know it, that child will grow up to become a professional liar. And when you now tell the child not to lie, he just laugh you to scorn. Who taught me? Who was my teacher? So parents, we should watch the way we live our lives before our children, because we are the mirror they are building. Daddy said, some men have girlfriends and their children are aware of it, but they beg them never to tell their mothers. Some even bring such ladies home and bribe their children to keep their mouths shut. How can such children ever grow up to become faithful to their spouses? They can't, because they've seen it in daddy. They've seen it in mommy. And when daddy travel out, mommy used to bring boyfriend, men friend home. They've seen it in mommy. And when daddy is not at home, mommy will leave them to house help and go out with other men. So they now grow up, you said they should be faithful. They can't be faithful because they've not found daddy and mommy being faithful to one another. The strongest legacy you can give to your children is to live the kind of life you desire to see in them. You want your children to be faithful, be a faithful person. You want your children to be hardworking, be hardworking yourself. Be diligent. You want your children to serve the Lord. Be totally lost in the things of God. You want your children to be prayerful. Be a praying mother. Let them see it in you. So daddy is saying the best legacy, the strongest one we can leave our children is to live the kind of life we desire them to see, to live, we desire to see in them. Prayer point. I want to say, Father, help me to lay a very solid foundation for every member of my family. It is time for parents to pray. Father, you need to pray. Mothers, you need to pray. Many of us have been stumbling block on the way of our children. All they grow to see in us, we ministers, is complaining and murmuring. And so none of our children want to grow up to be ministers of the gospel. Women, what your children grow up to see is to hear you backbiting and gossiping. No wonder they grow up to bring problem into the life of others. They set apart the best of friends through their gossips. Why they learn from you. Let's first and foremost confess our shortfalls to the Lord Jesus Christ. Fathers that have been drunkards, mothers that have been unfaithful to their spouses, let's tell God we are sorry in whatever way. Particularly those of us who are born again, we are the one not allowing our children to serve God in the church where we are because of our lifestyle. They know we are Christian in the church. We are something else in the house. We are always coming to talk about A, B, C, and D. We talk ill of our pastors. We talk ill of our senior pastors. And we now turn around to tell the children to accept Jesus. They look at us and they wonder, are we born again ourselves? Let's repent and ask God to make us a role model to our children in good things. Lord, I want to be a good example for my children. I want to be a good example for my children. Help me, O God. Help me, my Father. Help me, my King, that they can see Jesus in me and follow my Jesus. I want them to be spiritually strong, my King. Thank you, Father. Lord, without you, we can do but nothing. As many as are truly repented, seeing that they are the cause of their children's waywardness, forgive them in Jesus' name. And as they have repented and called on you for mercy, Lord, such children, bring them back to yourself in Jesus' name. Altogether, I pray for myself and all my viewers that will help us to be role models, godly role models for our children in the name of Jesus. That through our lifestyle, our children will fall in love with you in Jesus' name. Every faulty foundation in the lives of our children, we pray that in mercy you will rebuild for us in Jesus' name. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can we please sing hymn 16?
Sing out, yeah.